folks, Will from MinIO here with a little how-to on creating a web page using Go and MinIO. And in this video, we're going to be working with Go 1.19. We're going to be connecting to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all this out of VS Code. Now, I am by no means a skilled HTML developer. I'm not a web front-end developer, so everything you're going to see in here is going to be very, very basic. But I am going to show you how you can use Go to handle both uploading a file as an object and also listing the files and displaying them in a web page. So let's go ahead and take a look at some code. And just a quick reminder, I'm not really going to show you how to build a fully functional web page. This is just a couple of little examples here. So I've got some additional imports here that I have in my main package, largely to deal with all of that fun stuff around building HTML and working with HTTP commands. So a couple of items here. I'm creating a constant part size, which is going to handle both my multi-part form input, and it's also going to handle my part size when I'm actually uploading to MinIO. So it's handy to have this. 10 megabytes is what I've set it to. 5 megabytes would be the smallest that MinIO can handle. Also, I'm going to put everything into my Go demo bucket, and I'm creating that Go demo bucket with this Play Connect. Now, I'm going to be reusing this MinIO client both as an upload file handler and a list files handler. And what I've got here is for my local host, I've got a slash upload endpoint, which is going to show me a little form that I can upload a file with. And then I'm going to have this slash files endpoint, which is going to allow me to actually list the files in my Go demo bucket under a specific prefix. So let me show you all this. I'm going to fire up my server. And then here in my upload file handler, here's what's going to happen whenever I'm running this. So I click on my form, I get my info here, we have this parse multi-part form right here with my part size. And then if there's an error, I'm going to say, hey, there was an error here or whatever. But notice I have this parse files template here. This is my upload template. That is just the most basic HTML you can imagine. Let me show it to you real quick. This is it. This is the whole thing. It's 14 lines of HTML, and it's not pretty. It is not pretty. I will freely admit that. But it does have a logo. It's got a nice little multi-part form. And it calls the upload action there. It does a post, it takes a file name, and then it's got a little submit button. That's it. So if I go back to this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab that upload file from the form. I'm going to parse it into a file and a file header. Now the file header is going to allow me to do some things like get the file name and the size, which I'm going to need when I do my upload. And then I also am going to get the whole file into this file bytes. I'm doing this file byte so that I can use HTTP's detect content type to figure out my detected file type. And I'm doing a little parsing here because my file types sometimes don't agree with what MinIO is expecting. But that's okay. It's not a big deal. What I'm doing here is then I am actually just doing a printout here so that I know that I'm actually detecting things. Don't worry about that. But here I'm going to do this MinIO client put object, which you may have seen from a previous how-to. Again, this put object is going to take a stream. So I'm actually going to do a file bytes, a new reader on this stream. I'm going to upload it as the file name that I read to an uploads prefix. So I want to always send it to the uploads prefix. And then I've got a bucket name there. I've also got the file size, so I know how big I'm going to write here. I have a part size and a content type in my put object options as well. And what's gonna happen is it's gonna try to write that. If it can't, it's gonna give me an error with a little internal service error. And then I'm gonna output back to my browser that I successfully uploaded this file with a certain content type. It's really no huge thing. Ultimately, what I'm showing you here is some very basic code. This is not, like I said, gonna be a very pretty web page. The list files handler, same sort of thing. I'm going to list my objects, and again, I'm literally just doing this with text. I'm not showing you any really clever HTML here. But I'm going to do a list objects on my bucket, that same bucket name, and then I'm going to do versions, and I'm gonna do a recursive true so that I can see these things. If I don't do a recursive true, I can't see down into the uploads, but I am limiting this just to the uploads, and you'll see why in just a minute. And so for each object in my object channel that comes back, I'm going to print out the key and the e tag and the version ID and then a new line. And then I'm going to write that all back out to the browser, and that's it. And then I've got this render error, this clever render error item here. I actually pulled from a GitHub example. This is a GitHub example by a gentleman by the name of ZupZup. I will pass the GitHub source for this so that you guys can see the GitHub source for this as a link here on the video. So ultimately, that is going to allow me to run all of this. So let's go ahead and come down here to my terminal, and I'm going to fire this up. And there's really not a lot that's going to happen here. I'm going to do a go run dot, and it's just going to sit here. It's going to say my server started, and it's just going to sit for a minute. Okay. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go over to a browser now, because this is all designed to run in a browser. I'm going to show you some stuff. Okay, and this is actually out on play.min.io. I wanted to show you the Go demo bucket that I have. Now notice, right now there's no uploads prefix, but there are a couple of files, the image PNG and the hello world text that I was working with in some of our other videos. But let me go ahead and now show you right here, I'm gonna upload a file. So if I do a choose file, this takes me out here. I'm gonna go ahead and upload this IMPNG right here. And when I say open, it lists it as the file that I'm gonna do, and I click on upload it, and amazingly, there you go. So, successfully uploaded images, IMPNG with content type image PNG. So I got my right content type there and all that other fun stuff. So let me go back to my MinIO console. Let me reload this page. And now as you can see, I've got an uploads and I've got an IMPNG in there. So let me go back to this. I'm gonna change my address. I'm gonna go to the files endpoint, and when I click on the files endpoint, there you go, my list of objects, uploads, IMPNG, and I've got the e tag, and I've got a version. Now notice, hello world text and image PNG that were in the root of that bucket, not listed because I did recursive and I limited it just to my uploads. Let me go ahead and upload another file. Let's go ahead and upload that hello world text one more time. We'll go ahead and upload it. There we go. So if I go out to my MinIO console now and I reload here in my uploads prefix, I see that I've got an HW text. By the way, this HW text has some versions because I uploaded it there three times. So now if I go back and I go to my files, there we go. I've got three versions of HW text and one version of IMPNG. So that's listing all of my versions. It does a recursive listing so I can see everything under uploads. But again, I'm limiting it just to the uploads prefix so that you can only see what's in the uploads directory. So that's everything that I wanted to show you here about my simple web page using Go and MinIO in the back end. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen, or you can chat with us interactively on slack.min.io. Or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.